Aboriginal leaders and constitutional law experts have cast doubt over Linda Burney's declaration in Parliament that The Voice won't give advice on changing the date of Australia Day. Joining me now live is independent member Kylea Tink. Thank you so much for joining us. Do you think there's enough information on this proposal? Does the Yes campaign need to clarify its message here?
I think the most important thing from where we are now, Danica, is that the debate really comes out of Parliament House and goes into the community. And some would say it's been a long time coming. I think what we're seeing at the moment is party politicking. It's the worst of party politics in Canberra. I'm much more concerned for the conversation that people will be having on the ground. And I believe that once people start having those conversations, they're going to find if they stay open in this conversation and agree to listen to each other respectfully, we will find a way through it. All the information is there. But you're not going to find that information if you're just watching us down in Parliament House and watching the circus. That is question time. Don't bother, would be my advice. My advice would be get out there, talk to people who are connected to the movement, and both sides. If you're undecided, inform yourself, because actually the most important thing that we can achieve as a nation is a way through this that keeps us together and ensures that when your vote is cast, you voted it in a way that you feel you did so fully informed and not driven by just some ridiculous headlines.
Yeah, it's certainly been an interesting debate so far. Let's move on. I want to ask you about industrial relations. Businesses will today step up their IR relations ad campaigns. Do you think that the government has acted in good faith on these reforms as it says it has?
We've got a long way to go in these reforms, and I think what is important for all Australians to know is that we are still very much in the consultative process. So it is important that any business out there or any entity that recognises businesses, represents businesses, they should be reaching out and getting involved in this consultative process. My biggest concern when it comes to reform like this is that we seem to be This government seems to be taking an approach that where there's a problem in one specific area, rather than address that problem, that industry, that area, we're applying a one-size-fits-all solution to that business problem. And I don't think punishing the many to capture the few is the way that Australian business wants to be able to move forward. So it is really important. These are not wide sweeping reforms that are required. This is specific change that is required in specific industries and areas, and that's what I'll be working with the government to continue to advocate for, because otherwise there's going to be unintended consequences. And our economy, our workers, our businesses, they can't afford that, because there are no jobs for workers if there aren't healthy businesses. So we have to find a way through this together.
I want to move on now. Let's talk about the nature repair market bill. It's something that you're quite passionate about. It's up for debate again today. There's said to be possibly a Senate clash on this. Firstly, what's your position on this bill?
The nature repair bill is less than ideal. Many Australians out there would know that, you know, we went through a process of review around our environmental protections over the course of the last 2 years, and from that came a report called the Samuel Report. And it had a number of sweeping recommendations that were a way for us really to press Control-Alt-Delete on biodiversity and managing our natural resources in this country. What I find frustrating is that the government's decision to start with this particular piece of those recommendations, it's like the 29th recommendation out of 38. What we fundamentally need is a new national framework to ensure that any decision we're making when it comes to our natural resources, our environments, our endangered species, is being made in a way which is consistent with us protecting our long-term future. You know, I was speaking to someone this morning. The comment he made to me is that we need to stop thinking about climate change as something that is going to happen to our children. Climate change has come early. It is happening now. And whether we like it or not, Australia has the highest rate of mammal extinction in the world, not just as a country, as a continent. We actually outperform continents.